Welcome students in my new tutorial, and today I'll be teaching you about the basics of LibreOffice Writer. So first of all, I'll be opening my LibreOffice, and this is a basic interface. So from here I'll be opening Writer document. So this is the basic interface of LibreOffice. And you will find quite similar to MS Word, and it's little different in this way, like tabs are there. If you're not able to see these tabs, it's very easy. You can click upon View, and there you will find the option User Interface. You can click upon this User Interface, and then from here you can click upon Tabbed. By default, it may show like this in your case. So it may show like this when you will open your LibreOffice Writer. So how to again go for that interface? You will click upon View option, User Interface. And from here you can click upon Tabbed and apply to all. Means this setting will be applied for all the softwares. That means for regarding spreadsheet also, presentation also. So as a result, you will see the tabs are there on the top. In case you could see here different menu. If you want to close this menu, what you could do in the tab view here you could find here menu bar. You can just click upon this, and as a result now you can't see the menu on the top. And again, if I'll click upon this menu bar again, you will be able to see different menus. So this tutorial will include the basics of LibreOffice Writer, same like MS Word. So I have choose this option because it gives me the same comfort of MS Word, which I was missing in OpenOffice Writer. So directly I'll be typing something. Suppose I'll write here. I love my parents. And I'll copy and paste it again and again, just to save the time. Okay, so I just copied some of the text. The same way you could also do. Now I want to try out the different options, and it's very easy. Simply I'll firstly copy some of the text. I'll copy Control C works here also. Or you could click upon this copy option here, Control C, keyboard shortcut. And I'll press Enter key here. Now, I love my parents. I copied and pasted on the top. And I want to make it in the center. So you could see here the center, and the keyboard shortcut is also same, Control E. Okay. And then to make it bold, you can click upon this bold option, Control B, keyboard shortcut is same. And then if I want to increase the size of this text, you could see here two options, increase font size, decrease font size. Yes, keyboard shortcut is changed now. Earlier it was Control Shift and greater key to increase and decrease to lower the size. Now it's changed. So for increasing the font size, Control and angle bracket like this, or I can press Control and angle bracket and it will increase the size. So I hope it is clear to you. The same way, if I want to change the font color, it's here. You can choose any color of your choice, and same way custom color, if you want, you can choose from here. So it's very easy. And then background color, if you want, you can just select from here. You can choose Or if I want to choose somewhere in between, I can choose here also. And it also has the option of custom color. So by default, it selects the whole paragraph. So this is the background color. And now if you want to change character highlighting color, so this is here. So what I'll do, in between, I want to change the color here. So I can do it. Yes, it's working. So background color is working for whole paragraph, and for individual character formatting, you can click from here. So it's working. Okay. Then set line spacing. This is very important. Suppose I have selected this text. I want to increase the space of the lines vertically. Then this will be very beneficial for me. I'll click upon this. Set spacing 1, you could see here the difference. Set spacing 2, so I hope it is clear to you. Then increase indent. Suppose the whole paragraph I want to shift little bit right side, so I can increase the indent. And decrease indent, again I can decrease in this way. So I hope these options are very much clear to you. Bold italic underline, just I'll select it from here. Italic underline, so these are the options. And with the underline, you can select the underline options from here. So it's working. Now along with this, you want to change the font, same like MS Word. From here, different fonts are there. You could change it according to your choice. Whatever the available fonts are, you could just choose from here. Now from here, there is one clone option. So I was just telling you about this clone option. Its work is same like Format Painter in MS Word. So if I want to select the formatting options of this text, so what I'll do, I'll just select this text by pressing the left mouse button. Then I'll click upon this clone option. If I'll click single time, it will work one time only. Like suppose if I'll click it here and I'll select it here, so you could see it's working. And but again, if I want to use, it's not working. So if I want that, it should paste the formatting options again and again. So again, I'll select it and then I'll double click it, two times click. Now wherever I want to use this, suppose here, 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 it's working. So I hope this option is also very much clear to you. Now, if I want to insert borders on a page, how I should do it? I'll just click upon layout. Now, from the layout option, you could see here page size. Click upon this page size, more options you could see, and here you could find borders. Now from here you can select the styles. Suppose I'm selected this thick, thin, large gap, and color I'll select according to my choice. And then from here I can select all four borders and click upon apply or OK. You could see here the border. There is one another option also from where you could go to the borders. And for that, what I'll do, I'll click upon view. And from here, I'll select menu bar. Now from the format menu, there is one option here. Page style. Okay. Format. Page style. Now from here also, this page style default page style dialog box will be in front of you. And again, the border option will be there. You can choose the required options according to your choice. Thickness also, you have the control. You could select the thickness. So I'll click upon OK. So I hope this is also very much clear to you. So I'll again close this menu bar. And also, I'll off this clone option. For offing it, again I'll click, and now it's off. Now there is one option, an ordered list and ordered list. If I want to use this option, ordered list, that means for making the list. So I can use, I'll just select, change the font here. And now if I'll use the list, like ABC, BC, D, EF, G. So I'm just making some random list. I'll just decrease the size of the text. So it's looking like this. And from here, you could choose any kind of ordered list according to your choice. You could see here. Size I'll set according to my choice. So it's looking okay now. So the same way you can select an ordered list also. It will work. So I hope this is also very much clear to you. So now if I want to insert any image, how will I insert it? I'll click upon insert option. And here, see two, three options is in front of you. Gallery is there, image is there, media is there. So if I click upon gallery, you could see here on the right side, gallery is open. So from here, you can select any of the image provided in the gallery according to your choice. So in this way, I am able to insert the image. And suppose this image only I want to clone. So you know very well, Control C and Control V, you could do Control C and Control V. And then you can easily rotate. You can right click upon this. And here, there you will find the option rotate. Now you could rotate. So intentionally, I have copied the same image which I have downloaded from the gallery, and then I rotate it so that you should learn how to rotate. It's easy. Right click option, many options are there. Toggle point edit mode. So you could increase, and where you could find this dot, na, this circle. From here, you could do the changes in the image. You could see here like this. The same way here also. So I hope you have learned how to control this. Add text box. Here you can write. Suppose I have written arrow. So for this, I'll just increase the size so it could be visible. So I can increase the size of the written text. So from here I can increase the size. Now dear students, after you have learned how to rotate the image and how to insert the text, now we'll be inserting some image. So I'll click upon after insert image from here. And whichever images you have downloaded, so I can select any image which I have downloaded. Suppose this image I am taking. So here you have the control to decrease the size as you were having in MS Word. The same way you can insert the image. And right click, the options are there of cropping if you want to crop it like this. And other options, wrap, that means after the text or through the text. Suppose I can click upon, you could see here the text. I'll show you here. Okay, so these are the options of wrap. None, nothing, wrap, parallel. Now means the image is in between. Parallel means the text is surrounding. In background option, that means the image has gone in the background. So I hope all these options are very much clear to you. And if I'll go to the next page, here I have the option to insert the table. Here you can insert the table. You can select how many rows and columns. So you can select, suppose here you can write name, roll number, class. So like this, you have the option to create the table. And once the table is been selected, like I am in the table. So table tab is here on the top and it has different options. So just now I was just giving you the basic explanation about the basic tools and basic interface of LibreOffice Writer. So I hope my tutorial is becoming too lengthy. So I'll be stopping my tutorial here only. And from next tutorial, I'll be covering according to the syllabus of CBSC IT Skill 402. So with this, I'm closing my tutorial. And if you like my explanation, then please do like, share and comment. And also subscribe my channel if you have not subscribed it earlier. Okay, bye-bye. Meet you soon in my next tutorial.